Back in my day, when I was coming out, we didn't have this little thing called the internet that lets people share their experiences and know that there really are folks just like them out there.
I grew up in a small town with a very traditional family who, after I went to college and discovered that I was bisexual, didn't necessarily appreciate it.
Growing up gay and Asian in a suburban New Jersey school was difficult.
One of the huge motivators for me becoming a teacher was my own middle school and high school experience. Even though I didn't have a lot of bullying applied to me, I remember feeling really isolated.
I was not even aware of my sexuality, but I knew I was depressed and down about it in high school.
I remember my high school years as being very lonely at times. I felt very isolated. Sometimes I felt like I was an odd duck.
Sitting in assembly, surrounded by many other boys, when the principal, what we called the High Master, said, "Homosexuals deserve our pity and our prayers." And I remember sitting amongst my peers and feeling totally alone.
When I went into the military, don't ask, don't tell was not yet the law, and it was actually even worse. I had to sign a document that affirmed I was not a homosexual.
I can remember when I was a young teacher in my 20s, how terrifying it was coming out, knowing that I could easily be fired simply for being gay. Myself and several other teachers in Boston organized, got protection in the collective bargaining agreement around issues of sexual orientation, and we marched in Gay Pride Parade in 1978 with bags over our heads so people would not see us.
There's a lesson that took me a long time to learn. When people say mean-spirited things, it's a reflection of them and not me. The older you get, the wiser you get. And that's one reason it gets better.
It gets better.
It gets better.
It does get better.
I think there's a lot that we can do to actually make things better. There are so many GSAs, gay straight alliances, in schools across the country.
People are more educated and aware that there's differences in life, and life gets better.
It will definitely get better, so hang in there. There are plenty of people around you who admire you. There are plenty of people you have yet to meet who will love and admire you and appreciate all that you are.
Every one of you is talented, great, and awesome in your own way, and all of us are just waiting to get to meet you. So please hang in.
I want you to know that it gets better. There's people who will just see the gifts inside you and cherish you for exactly who you are.
There are plenty of us out here. We're all here. We all love you. We can all support you, and you will succeed and you can make a difference.
It gets better.
It gets better.
It gets better.
It gets better.
I would not have expected that within a little over 15 years, I would have been appointed by the President of the United States, Bill Clinton, to a senior position in the U.S. Department of Education. And now I'm teaching here at Harvard as an openly gay faculty member, and believe me, life gets better.
So, wait for it, work for it, and remember, it gets better. Thanks.
It's really gotten better, and I encourage you to hang in there.
It gets better.
It gets better. I promise.